Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Bite. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today I talk about social engineering and scammers. As you know, October is Cybersecurity Awareness Month, and to celebrate that, I'm doing a video every week covering some theme about cybersecurity, and today's theme is on social engineering and scammers. As you surely know, social engineering is just a term to describe when malicious hackers use psychological tricks to get victims to do things they shouldn't, whether it be sharing information or clicking links or downloading attachments. Now, there's many types of social engineering. Some happens over email, some happens over voice calls, some may even happen in person. But today I just want to talk about a couple things that social engineers prey on to actually trick you into doing stuff or bait you into doing stuff you shouldn't. So let's talk about that. The first thing that social engineers might use to trick you is your own curiosity. For instance, say there's some popular topic on the internet one day or some big pop culture incident. Often, social engineers or scammers might use that topic to lure you into interacting or clicking with something they might send you. Another thing social engineers might use is your greed. Often, scam emails offer some sort of free deal or some sort of huge discount on something. You probably, of course, remember Nigerian scam emails which claim to reward you with big sums of money if you help them out. Speaking of helping out, another thing social engineers use is a human's desire to be helpful. For instance, a lot of these social engineering emails might start with somebody that says they're in distress asking for your help. This could be some Nigerian prince, as you've seen in the classic 419 emails, or it could be someone pretending to be your friend that says they're stuck in a country and need a wire transfer. Anyway, social engineers know that we like to help other people and they sometimes use it against us. Another example of this is social engineers taking advantage of tragedy, something I really hate. Whether it's a flood, a hurricane, an earthquake, or a big natural disaster, often a big global tragedy generates a lot of social engineering emails where the attacker will pretend to be a charitable organization and ask you for your donation. Finally, one of the last things social engineers use is your fear. Basically, there's a lot of types of social engineering emails or calls where they want you to be scared of something and take an action. For instance, in one of my past videos, I talked about an email where attackers claimed they had compromising video of you, which they stole from your webcam. In this particular type of email, they tend to have something like one of your leaked passwords, which seems to give them some sort of legitimacy to how they gained access to your computer, but the truth is they're just trying to scare you into doing something. Another example of this is scareware. It might be either a tech support call or an email or maybe even a pop-up on a website claiming that you have malware on your computer, and they try to scare you into interacting with them, whether that be clicking on a certain link to install a free copy of antivirus software or by allowing a tech support rep to do a remote desktop session to your computer. In any case, these fear tactics are just ways to trick you into doing things that you shouldn't. Oh yeah, one other thing I want to mention is something called pretexting. In a lot of these social engineering scams, the social engineer will pretend to be someone that somehow knows you, whether it be pretending to be one of your real friends or coworkers, or at least pretending to be someone you might have interacted with before in a business context. If you ever get emails that claim that you haven't contacted them since that last meeting where you and them decided to do something, often this is a pretexting means of trying to convince you to do something. You probably have never had such a meeting with this particular individual. In any case, these are all social engineering strategies that you should be aware of. There's no perfect way to protect against them other than just be aware that they're out there. You probably will sometimes get emails that do have good deals that are legitimate. Sometimes you do get real emails from coworkers or friends who need help. So you can't just ignore everything out there. However, when you do get these emails, just be aware of these sorts of social engineering psychological tricks. Be wary of clicking on links or attachments in these type of emails. Be wary of giving too much information over the phone to random folks who call you, especially if you haven't validated somehow that they really come from where they say they do. Long story short, find some other way to validate the emails or the phone calls you sometimes get from these folks. folks and realize that most of the time, legitimate companies do not directly email or call you directly. They usually wait for you to call or contact them. Anyways, that's it for today's cybersecurity awareness tips. If you want more details, be sure to check out the blog post associated with this video, as I'll have links to other places that describe these sorts of social engineering attacks. That's it for today's video. Thank you for watching.